A friend on YouTube is in the process of describing a symbolic inner journey, which I'm finding really interesting. But it reminded me of a trip I took to Santorini a couple of years ago, and in fact it bears quite a significant resemblance to it, and I felt inspired to describe that to you. I will give you some images, but what I find so interesting is thinking about it in relation to this other story, that the symbolism in mine works on a number of levels, and it works historically and physically. I think we tend to think often that symbolism works only in the mind, in dreams or in ideas and thoughts, but actually, of course, there are symbols out there in everything that we do. The story anyway has quite a significant meaning for me on a number of levels, and please read it however you wish and take whatever meaning you would like from it. The story begins. Until about 3,000 years ago, Santorini was sort of more or less round, at which point it blew itself to pieces. It is a volcano, highly active still, now a caldera. Most of it is well beneath the surface, so the whole island sits on a pool of lava, basically. It's believed that it actually caused the parting of the Red Sea, because a tsunami obviously extended out, because it literally blew most of itself away. The volcano sits at the centre, or the active and visible part of it does, but the around it is between 2 and 4 kilometres deep, so no boats can actually set up in the port. They have to kind of float about. But it is possible to visit the volcano itself and walk up it, which is what I did, even though it's highly active and still does quite a lot from time to time. So you can get about a boat out there, which is what I did. And it's fascinating. You could go and swim in the sulphur pools which were nearby and actually see the bubbles coming up and the sulphur at the bottom. It was quite hot, the water changed temperature quite significantly, and while I was there a huge raven came and alighted and watched the whole proceedings, which was fascinating. After that, you could walk up the volcano. About 3/4 of an hour. Walking up a highly active volcano is a fairly interesting experience, especially since when you remove the surface for about a couple of inches, you see steam pouring out and it is literally red hot. You're walking on the top of a very hot, very active volcano. Another interesting thing is that they discovered a village very recently that was covered in about 30 metres of volcanic ash. And what was particularly interesting was that there was nobody there other than one pig. The place was active. Everybody had left, but there was food there. One wonders what they knew, how they managed to leave, because there was nobody there inside. So what does all that show, other than the fact that I could do with getting a bit better at narration? I suppose I tend, whilst I'm extremely rational, to not see only the physical as significant. I don't see there being a clear and defined line between that which lies beyond us and that which lies within us. I think there are lessons to be learnt in history, in physical things taking place, whether they be geographical or man-made, and the sort of meanings that we take from experiences that we have can offer us an awful lot more than perhaps we might imagine. It's not about just taking some kind of shamanic journey. our whole life is a journey from moment to moment, and whether we choose to open our eyes to what is in each moment is up to us. And it does go very deep. There's a lot that lies way beneath the surface, just like the caldera in Santorini. And I think we would do well to remember that, if at all possible.